I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Boy, we've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
We need a doctor, not a dead man. Fail to meet my expectations and there will
don't
be...
Don't look straight into the light.
James and his cheery chatter.
May your future be bright for you, James. This place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. There you go. My good... Goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Mama?
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
These experiments
are a damn. The experiment to prepare. Prepare.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother...
young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... You're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Okay, okay. One last question. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. Yeah, I found this in a box of my father's old things. Can you believe it? Kind of weird to think about him reading comic books. I guess I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday!
Oh man, you got a pip.
Happy birthday!
Attention, everyone! It's
how's it going,
time
pal?
To cut the cake!
Hey, wait! Nice shit, boy. What is that? One of the 3000 A models? What piece of...
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Junk. I think you have to wind it up every...
Oh, no!
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am, rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
I would offer you a piece of cake, but...
Hey there, butt breath.
Nice party, butthead.
I told you not to act all official. I know
happy birthday, Sonny.
But I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nonsense. People all...
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Mrs. Palmer said I didn't have to share. Who's talking about sharing, moron? I want the whole thing. Now are you gonna give me that sweet roll, or am I gonna have to give you a knuckle sandwich? Gah, I don't want your nerd cooties. You're gonna be sorry you did that. We'll see how tough you are later when the grown-ups aren't around.
Butch's such an idiot. Just ignore him. Come on, don't ask me that. You know he would if I asked, but where would that leave me? It's bad enough being the overseer's daughter. If everyone knew I ran to Daddy every time I had a problem, nobody would ever talk to me again. We'll think of some way to get Butch back, I promise. But I'm not getting my father involved.
Enjoying
come
yourself?
On, Molly. You always have good ideas.
Yeah,
thanks
I got
coming,
one.
Stanley.
The Mackers.
I know you were busy.
Super
with the
cool,
water
right?
Jeez,
happy
Molly.
Birthday!
Who's the head of the gang? You or me?
Oh,
no
sure.
Way.
Jonas.
Don't worry about me and Andy got her all fixed up again last
we're
night.
All set down here.
I wasn't worried.
Thanks. I'll send him right down.
Right?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Anyway, I'm glad you can make it.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
How are you enjoying the party?
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine. Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
It's her fault anyway, so I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class,
eh? Get out of my way, you stupid...
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. Didn't work on your dad either, did it? Now, unless you have something else you want to discuss, take a seat and prepare for the 2274 edition of the goat. Listen, I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come out, and I'll take care of it for you. Well, all right. Here, take a look.
Back off.
I'll see you tomorrow, right now.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
That is the promise. It is safe. Is it? Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. I thought so too, but it's true. He's gone, and Jonas is dead, and now they're looking for you! My father's men think Jonas helped your dad escape. They caught him and brought him to my dad's office, and they... Oh my god. Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there!
Crime anymore!
You gotta help me! No. Oh my god!
What's happening? Ah, stop it! Come on, stop that!
I can find their quarters.
We did it! My mom's gonna be okay! You're the best friend I've ever had, man! Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely. That is all.
Ah!
Ah, young sir! How very good to see you!
Let's go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just... like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us.
In the name of the overseer. What's the matter, huh? Can't stand the sight of your own blood? You like that, you bastard?
That's enough. Officer. Be reasonable, Amata.
Hold it right there!
Just tell us where to find your friend. I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble at... I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow but I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then, if you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault. A regrettable incident. But sometimes harsh measures are necessary for the good of the vault. Such has always been my lot. Think a moment. If you really care about your fellow citizens, killing me is the worst thing you could do. Without an overseer, the vault would be plunged into chaos and disaster. Surely you can see that as well as I. Come now, turn your... Do you think I'm scared of a little snot-nosed punk like you? I was running this vault when you were still crying for your dead mother. You'll get nothing from me. I'll die before I see the safety of the vault compromised again. My God, you're a cold-blooded little shit, aren't you? I think you'd actually do it. Here, take them and leave the vault. I'll have you shot on sight if you ever come back.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry.
Thank you!
I thought about it for
a
long time.
I told you my father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along.
So many
things could have
gone wrong.
I'll try to meet you at the vault door. If I don't make it...
The Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. Was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay. Go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
I almost didn't believe it was possible.
No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's you. It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Look out!
I knew you'd turn up sooner or later. I'm not crazy enough to go out there.
pay.
Ah, welcome, weary traveler. You look like a traveler in need of relaxation. Well, wander no more, my good friend, for I am Doc Hoff, procurer of the finest of medical goods and chemical assistance. Now, how may I help you? Cheers.
Another newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too when the need arises. Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like. I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with? Nope, sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town. What about it? I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good? Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you. Not an option, I'm afraid. We aren't exactly rolling in cash down here. Great. Go ahead and see what you can do. Just be careful. Good luck.
Be blind with his glory. Every ear shall be stricken deaf to hear the thunder of his voice.